floors.
Oh, she's on the high side at least.
Good morning.
Okay, guys, we are headed up to meet up with the Kelowna Snow Wheelers.
Remember it last year we went with them. Through here, but
so hopefully we find some snow today. We just got to keep going up in elevation, and we should find some. But we already, as you're driving out here, each gas station you pass, you see some of the guys that are coming out. These trucks are freaking monsters. So can't wait to get up here, get unloaded, and we'll show you some of the freaking trucks.
I take his front door off. Woo!
How's your first half hour?
Good.
You did awesome, man. Like, you were right there.
It's going to take a little bit of getting used to, but
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll have it figured out.
Did you hammer through that one big
bump? Chapter pin.
Gary's laughing. Oh, he hit her full speed.
The only issue is he didn't have the camera running.
Oh, yeah, dang. Oh, yeah, yeah.
See much.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, poor Scott. Right on. All right, if you guys don't know, I don't know if I said it, but Jimbo bought our white Sherp, so this is his first, like, half hour of driving. So, like I said, they're not very difficult to drive, especially on a trail, but once you start getting out into, you know, getting out into this, there's certain little tricks and stuff you need to get around. So, but yeah, he'll learn a lot today, so can't freaking wait, man. Such an awesome group, like always. These Kelowna Snow Wheelers are freaking mental. The same Ford Ranger from last year. Woo! That big beast of a Ranger. God, every single rig is so freaking rad. just getting into dragon diffs. So this shows you, man, it is not easy getting around. This truck is such a freaking beast. Freaking echo off the trees. Oh my god, that was deadly. Wow. It's pretty optimal conditions for the Sherp today in these big tires. The snowpack is pretty stiff. Yeah. And once they've where they've gone through, yeah. Yeah, I'd be probably thigh deep if you could get all the way to the ground. Okay, let's catch up with everyone. So it doesn't really look like anything, but there's a bit of an incline here, so you match 4 or 5 feet deep snow. Joel just wants a clear path here where he can just light it up. God, it's so hard. Sorry, guys. Sorry. Joel's gonna be coming flying around that corner. Mock chicken. Just called it perfectly. I'm like, Joel's backing up, he's gonna be coming around this corner. Oh my god, see, that thing is so quiet till he opens it up. Hey, what a freaking monster. Holy. Oh, Jimbo, we gotta build ourselves one of those.
It's a real tricky snow. These guys know, like, literally every trick in the book to, you know,
forward momentum.
Pack a little bit, go pack a little bit.
It's in the way.
Art's staying right on top, right?
Yeah.
This shows you the complex snow we're dealing with today. It's very stiff on top, and then once you break through that, it's nothing underneath. A little bit, like the Sherp doesn't really pack too much.
Yeah.
Exactly. Even though that one's not a Sherp trail, but this one.
I wonder if you went in front of them, you can.
Yeah, I can try. Just saying, in Dallas, it's like, you know, it's like winter's over, and then you come up here and it's like freaking awesome. On board with Chris. What are you running for a motor in here?
Twin turbo LS.
Oh wow.
Thank you.
awesome. Oh my god. You probably can't tell on video. We get some really nice lean in action there. This snowpack, it's really, like I say, when you break through that, man, it traps you in here. But these guys like been doing this for so long, they know every trick in the book, so. Doing like 60 miles an hour across 4 feet of snow. Oh my goodness. More fucking Ranger. Oh, I'm telling you, man, this snow is tricky. Quick little winch out here. Ski right there, a little turb ski action. Nice. Once he can get some momentum, then he can just layer on the wood. But it's tricky, right? You want to start off kind of slow so you don't just sink down. Ford Ranger's like, listen, I'm Ford Ranger. Oh, that was freaking awesome. Jimbo was talking to the owner He spent 10 years building this, you guys. He machined his own beadlocks. Everything's TIG welded. Just a freaking gorgeous build. Sorry, I just fell into a 4-foot hole here. What a beauty. Okay, guys, it's lunchtime. So we're just getting some firewood for cook some smokies. I think it's this big dead one. This guy right here, what do you think? Okay, here we go. Here we go. Maybe. Yes. Yes.
Go catch it.
Boom. Perfect. Okay, he might have it. This one. Here we go. Oh, dang. Stripped all the branches off. This is a good sized tree, you guys. And all the branches are jammed down into the snow, kind of creating drag. So, once he gets it going, it should break some of the branches off. It should be better. Or maybe try to drag from that end. God, this thing is gorgeous. Okay, he's got her slinged up on the fat end. See if this works a little better. That is a good sized tree, you guys. Go get her. Much softer here. So Devin was saying this truck here, full air suspension, 350k, is like 90k in the motor. Whipple charge 632. So they run air shocks so they can adjust everything each quarter independently. And the air tank is the frame of the motor. So this is where all the air is held. You can see a air fitting there. Yes, a frickin' savage truck.
to a point like this, and we'll get to right where you turn around, and it should just crawl right up and keep on going, not touching nothing.
Smokes, boys, we found some deep snow. Holy cow,
it's pretty much the perfect snow for the Sherp. We're making around pretty good.
Thank you. rolling.
Boys, that's right, that's the ostacruiser winch line extension. It's really good stuff and so light and easy to pack. Wow. Always just need that little bit, hey?
Just a touch.
Yeah, exactly. It's like a freaking 8-foot mound here. Oh my goodness. Front and rear winches if we need. Holy, that was crazy, you guys. Oh my god, this is freaking awesome. Can't tell on video, but we're headed up a bit of a grade this whole way. We're going uphill. Brick downhill, they would never have to back up, they would just go.
Okay, guys, so we are going to start making our way out. We're going out a different way than we came in. We're doing the big loop, so what a freaking awesome day. But we're not out yet, so we got quite a trek to get back to the truck. So we'll update you if we run into any funny stuff, but for now, we're going to start cruising.
Coming down the notch. Perfect.
Wow.
Like absolutely nothing. Well, almost. Perfect. Yeah, oh, you'll do it.
We might have to ride it out for a bit.
And out. See you later. And they're gone.
Well, what do you think? First day of ownership? Second day, but first day you didn't do anything.
Exactly. It was good.
Oh, good day. No, you did so good. And a really great day for a lot of learning. You learned a lot in a short time.
Oh, yeah. Learned so, that the fan doesn't come on all the time.
Yeah. Yeah, no kidding. So, yeah, we are just, well, we're still making our way down. We probably still got a good ways to go. But we couldn't waste the opportunity to stop and take a couple pictures. The sun setting, freaking gorgeous, man. It was supposed to rain all day, so I think we lucked out. No snow, no rain, other than a few times it snowed a little, but freaking gorgeous. All right, it is so hard to walk, you guys. you keep falling through or not falling through, and like that, like that. Oh, as I'm talking about how hard it is to walk this, just struggle bus. Oh, up to my freaking thighs. Okay, great freaking day. Ready? Oh, that was weird. Weird. It's like the camera knows it's fake. Just kidding. Okay, let's get cruising.